Good morning. Yeah, good morning, students. We're continuing with the reported speech that we had started yesterday. Hope you have your books with you today, right? And we'll be doing the questions in the book also. So yesterday we had discussed about interrogative sentences. Today we'll just do a little bit about imperative sentences before we move on to the exercises. Now, imperative sentences, it's a sentence that shows an order, a request, command, advice, what else? Suggestion? Yes? Right? And how, when we change such sentences, see the basic rules are the same. You have to see the reporting and the reported speech. They will change the tense accordingly. There will be change of the pronoun, right? And of course, here are things that you need to remember. When we talk about imperative sentences, it is the use of the infinitive to, right? The teacher ordered the students to open their books, right? The commander ordered the soldiers to open fire on the enemy, right? Mother requested child to bring her a glass of water. So what do we remember here? It is the use of to plus the verb that follows it, okay? So in case of a negative sentence, it would be not to, isn't it? Right? And of course, yes, generally when in imperative sentences, that is not used, okay? Right? So it is not introduced with the that, okay? And of course, all the changes are done as per the other rules. Now, what am I going to come to? We are going to start with here because you're going to get multiple choice questions. And in multiple choice questions, what is the biggest problem? That the answers are so close to each other, right? So here, once again, we have to remember, it is not only the verb that changes. We also have to see that the verb, it agrees with the subject also. Sentence has to be grammatically correct, right? So these simple things here, you need to remember. Now, all of you open your books here. Come on, all of you. Open your books to page 283. Open your book to page 283. And let's start here. What? Done in 9th? Never mind. Let me see if you remember it in class 10. Okay? Right? So I didn't have your class so then. Now I think so I'll have to send you exercises on my own if you have done this page. So those who have, you have not done it, you've got chance to complete it now, considering how, of course, here. Let's see. Where are you coming from? I am coming from the meeting. What was it about? So never mind, do it. Do it. See, exercise 11 I am not doing because that is your director. You know, like do as directed. We will discuss that also. Don't worry. I can make it in a multiple choice form also. Right? But let us do the multiple choices so that you get an idea how to select the correct answer. Where are you coming from? I am coming from the meeting. What was it about? It was about the formation of students' union in our school. So we have these dialogues here. As I told you, reported speech, you might get as a dialogue, you might get as a strip, also as a comic strip, you might get pictures, right? Now here, look at the answer which is given. It is given in the form of a paragraph. There are blanks. So we will have to change the sentence individually. And we will identify the correct option. So if your answer is correct, if you know all the rules and regulations here, all the things that you need to remember, your answer will be found in the options. Okay? Yes, all of you at home, can I see your books, please? Can I see your books? Offline students are having their books. I want the students at home to show me their books. Can you show me? No, ma'am, our book is very special. We're hiding it from you. You can't see a book. Is it? Right, let's start. Come on, take time and finish this blank here. Where are you coming from? First is done. What kind of a sentence is it? Interrogative. What are the things we have to remember? What are the things, basic, most important thing? Do we use that?
No.
No, that has to be there. It is there, a WH, you can say question. It's going to remain as such, right? Question mark will be removed. Very good. So these are the things you have to remember, okay? Right, and of course here, Manish asked Madhavi, where, change in pronoun, where she was coming from. Madhavi replied, now I am coming from the meeting. What kind of a sentence is it? I am coming from the meeting. It's a assertive, right? It's a statement, okay? So that she was coming from the meeting. Okay, fine. Can you find the correct answer? What was it about? Manish wanted to know. You people are so lucky, half the sentence has been done for you. So you just have to find half the blank, right? So it has started, you just have to complete it. So Manish, what was it about? Wanted to know what it was about. Okay, fine, correct, yes. So we are able to, it was about the formation of students' union in our school. Told that, yes, so that, yes, yes, it was about the formation of students' union in our school will become their school. So did you get the correct options, all of you? Did you get the correct options? Were you able to find the answer? Give me a yes or no, please. You can raise your hand. We people are so excited here. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Fine, fine. I can see the responses here. And yes, here. Yeah. Let's come to the next one. Do the next one. Where are you going? Yes, ma'am. You're not going anywhere. Yes, ma'am. You're in the class only. I am going to the airport. Why are you going there? My mother is to arrive from the US at 7:30 a.m. Rajiv asked Pradeep. And of course, here, please remember that option is correct because it does not have the question mark also at the end. Isn't it? Right? So where he was going? Yeah, which one? Third option? Then comes next one. I am going to the airport. Pradeep replied that he was going to the airport. First one, yes. Then comes the next one, Rajiv further inquired. So inquiry, he is asking so many questions. Yes. Why are you going there? Why he was going there. So second option and the last one. Pradeep told him that his mother was to come from the USA at 7:30 a.m. So that answer is given to AM ka AM hi rahega. Time ki change hoga. Who's saying AM ka PM ho jayega? Because America se aage India mein the time zone will change. Is it? Yeah, look at you all saying yes, also. Next one, come on, I want the answers hurriedly. Come, take 1 minute. Bhavan, be ready with the answers. Why are you late, Sam? I missed the school bus. You should have reached the bus stop on time. My mother is ill and was hospitalized yesterday. Oh, I'm sorry, Sam. Don't worry, she may get well soon. Yes, can I see the answers? Yes, Harshita and Chahat and others. Shivansh. And no one is showing me the book. Yes, Raghav, are you writing? Are you looking at the book? I'm not sharing the screen also. Yes, Krishan, Tarandeep, others also. Please tell me the option only, right? No need to write the correct answers and all. Sit down, you're not going anywhere. Why are you late, Sam? It's given to you, the answer was already given the first part. The teacher asked Sam why he was late. Sam replied that, yes, I missed the school bus. Already it is there, right? So it will become the what tense? Yes, he had missed the school bus. So it is second option. Next is, wait, the teacher told him that you should have reached the bus. He should have. Yes, so it is which option? One, first one, he should have reached the bus stop on time. My mother is ill, and we told him that Sam said that his mother was ill, and very correct, very correct, because it is already there, so we're going to make it into the past perfect, isn't it? Right, so she had been, yes, she had been hospitalized the other day. So it is, yeah, so the other day will become
previous day.
Oh my God, my offline students are so excited. Let's do the fourth one. I'll do a couple more and then we'll switch on to the other sentences. You've done it all?
Yes.
So, okay, I've lost my lucky bat with which I made all my runs. Tomorrow we go playing. Tomorrow we are playing at Delhi school. If confident, you can still make all the runs. Sanju told his father that, okay, one by one. Yes, let me hear. Hardik, give me the answer. Sanju told his father that
he had.
And you know, here, see, look at this sentence. Very correct. This sentence has two parts. So we have to remember that we should not miss out any part. Marsh, have you been able to find the sentence? Did you find the sentence? Yes. Did you find the answer? Okay, I'd like to hear your answer also. So remember here, if the sentence has two parts, we have to make sure that both the sentences, they will be treated as an individual sentence. And you have to solve it individually. Okay. Right, so Sanju told his father that he had lost his lucky bat. Which option is that? First one, yes, first one, with which he had made all the runs. He was all the more upset because, yes, because the next day they were playing at Delhi school. First option is the correct one. Did you get it? Did you get the answer? Yes. Then is he was all the more upset because, okay, his father assured him that
if confident he could.
Okay, with confidence he could still make all the runs, right? So it is, which part is it? Third part, right? Got it? Okay, so someone told me that ma'am, these are questions we have done. Can you move to exercise 13 then? You've done that also. Exercise 14 also. Exercise 15 have you done? The dialogue strips also. Very clever you are. Okay. Okay, okay, fine. So can we come to, yes. (11 and 10) you have not done. So we can do those. This is do as directed. But okay, fine. Let us start with exercise 10. All of you, come on, open your books and to page, which one page is it? Page 22. Right, let us do exercise 10 over here. It is once again your imperative sentences, isn't it?
So what are the rules that we need? When do we use let? When do we use let? Let us go for a picnic. Right? You're not requesting, you're making a suggestion. Let is not a request, right? Let, it can be an order also, it can be, right? So it is a suggestion, it's a proposal as an order, right? Okay, that don't let anyone enter my room, isn't it, right? So that is not allowing anybody here. So it can be an order, it can be a proposal, like as a friend, you're making that suggestion. So how generally we do use it, it is as, like, of course, he suggested, he proposed, right? He ordered him, right? So accordingly, the changes will be made. Now let's have a look at this here. Like, of course, there's a sentence here. Harish said to me, let us see a movie today. So among equals, among friends, what would it be? It's a suggestion. It's a suggestion. Yes, right? Or yeah, then as an order. So don't let anyone enter my room, right? Don't let anyone touch my bag. It's an order, okay, right? And of course, like as a proposal, you're suggesting let us do something. Come, let us watch this movie, right? Yes, so come and let's play cricket. So it is as a proposal, you are there, right? Asking them to do something along with you. So when we look at these sentences here, yes, come on. These are your doers directed here, and you'll be writing down the answers on the books. Let's see your answers now. So you can write it on a page and then paste it. You can write it on a page and then paste it over here, so that when you do your revision, you have the answers with you. Okay? Right?
Yes.
Suresh said to Dinesh, let your younger brother do his home task peacefully in his room. Yes? Come on, let's do this. What is it? Is it an order? Is it a suggestion? What is it? Yes. It's a suggestion. So, of course, the imperative sentences, as I've told you, what are the things that we need to remember? To and where it is a direct order or a suggestion, we can use let also. Okay. Said to Dinesh will become Suresh told Dinesh. Now to the next part. Take a look at the pronouns that you have to change. Yes, yes. To let his younger brother do his in his room. Whose room is it? Brother's room. Okay. Yeah, his, yeah, guys, it'll be his. Teacher said to the boy, let none of you make any noise in the class. So it is an order. So teacher ordered the boys Yes. So
So let will become should. Let will become should. That none of them should make any noise in the classroom. Okay. So we here we have an example of an imperative sentence where we're using that also. Because let here, right? Let is there as an order. Okay. Right? As a command, right? So the teacher ordered the boy that none of them should make any noise in the classroom. Father said to me, don't let the dog jump in the flower beds. Said to me. Told me, simple. Suggested to hai nahi. It is not advised also. Right? See, when we had to do multiple choice questions, we were all jumping around and so noisy we were. And now when you have to do it, you know, individually as a sentence, it does take time to think. And this is what we need to do. Even when you're doing multiple choice questions, please don't be in such a hurry to answer the questions. Take time. Whenever we do grammar, one thing is there, just read the passage before you jump to giving the answers. Let us do this one. Yes, father told me. Order? Okay, father ordered me, commanded me, told me, you know, when we talk about here. Yes, right. You know, like order, command here, right? It would be maybe between, let's talk about subordinates and a superior role. These are the changes. What? That is what I'm telling you when you do your multiple choice questions here, right? We are there, you know, like, of course, here, like, see here, what is it? Father told me to not let the dog jump in the flowers. Mother said to Kavita, let the water in the kettle boil. Simple. Told, right? And not everything is in order. Not everything is in order. Right? And please, you know, like an order would be like a superior telling someone, right? A higher authority telling the someone. So when it is generally, yeah, like maybe a teacher telling the students, it would be an order. So mother is here, so right, we can say mother told Kavita to let the water in the kettle boil. Simple as that, it will change as, there's no change as it. Next one, the commander said to the soldier. Now you can write your favorite word. The commander ordered the soldiers to not allow or to not let any enemy plane or fly over the bunker. Those bunkers. These will become those. Krishna said to Kavita, come, let us have coffee, eat, and some snacks. What is it? It's a suggestion. It's a proposal. Yes. Krishna proposed or suggested to Kavita that. Yes. That they should have a coffee and some snacks in the restaurant. Right? Suresh said very angry, Ravindra is a stupid fellow, let him go to hell. Oh my God. Right? Said very angrily. What would come over here? We have to show that, yes, word here, let us write the correct word. I don't want you to write, you know, like the wrong answer here.
So Suresh said very angrily that Ravindra was a stupid fellow and he should go to hell, right? Because there are two paths, so we'll change both of them, okay? Right? Yes, yeah, so there it is, right? Said with anger. Yes, go. Pradeep said to us, Dinesh is very much worried about money. Yes, told us, Pradeep told us that Dinesh was very much worried about money. It's a simple thing, right? Yes. Next one. The teacher said to the boys, let your bags lie on your desk and go out and play. So teacher, let your bags lie down. So it's a, you can say it's an order, right? So the teacher ordered the boys to, or you can say, yes, to let the bags lay on their desks and go out and play in the ground. Okay, fine. Snehlata said to Karuna, we have nothing important to do. Come, let us see some good movie. Yes, so right. Snehlata suggested to Karuna that they had nothing important to do and they should go see or see what like could be watch some good movie. Okay, clear? Is this done? Right. Yes. So please here remember. Right, we are not doing into direct narration. Ours would be from direct to indirect. Yeah. And what are the things that we have remembered when we use let? What are the ways in which we use let here? Let is as an order. Yes. We have done sentences with where let is an order. Let is also a suggestion. Let is also a proposal, right? Or an advice also. Right? So, leave them alone and let them learn their lesson. Isn't it? Right? So, we can use that. And of course, here, according to the kind of sentence that we are going to write, we will use, you know, order and advise and suggested and command. Right? What is one thing that we really have to remember when we write a suggestion, when we write an order, when we write a command? To infinitive. Okay, this is where, and of course, when you have these sentences here, where let is there, right? So we also use that also. Okay, right? Is this clear? Any doubts? Any doubts? But now we need to practice with multiple choice questions. So I will be sharing with you. Let's see if I will be getting these, sentences some more. And I'll be sharing, right? So you can do it on your notebooks. Okay. So our work is over. You know, we finished Footprints Without Feet. And I want you to write a paragraph. Let us write a paragraph on, you can say, yes. Can we write a paragraph with reference to Footprints Without Feet on this? I ask you to write, we have to do discursive paragraphs. And discursive paragraphs is discussing any given topic. I have given you this topic in relation to the chapter that we have done. That is, which one? Footprints Without Feet. Now, with reference to that chapter, can you write a paragraph on this? Responsibility of a good science. Now, when we write a paragraph here, opening sentence, what can it be? Opening sentence, you can write about the scientist. Yes? Yes. So, who can use his inventions for the betterment of humanity, right? And a good scientist has a lot of responsibilities. And first of all, yes, what is one responsibility you think here? It is, yes, as you say, it is for better of society. It is there. He should not keep any kind of invention a secret, right? And it should be made for the benefit of the public. And a scientist needs to own responsibility. that if anything goes wrong, or he should not make his invention or discovery public until he is not sure of the consequences, right? So you can give an example also if you want to, right? So like a poor scientist there, like we talk about the nuclear bombs and the right atomic bombs and all, you talk about that, how much a big responsibility it is. So it can be used one simple formula. Mehul, what are you writing? Keep your book on the desk so I can see what you're doing. So one simple formula, it can be used in a positive way, it can be used in the negative way also, right? So here, like if you had to write this paragraph, not had to, you are going to write this paragraph, okay? So because here we will have to practice our writing skills simultaneously. Yes, please write it in your fair notebook. So responsibility of a good scientist. You can keep, you know, Griffin in mind. Was he a good scientist? He was a good scientist. He was intelligent. He was very hardworking, but his actions were not good because he did not understand his responsibility. Okay? Clear, all of you?
Yes.
Yes. So keep your books with you, only your grammar books, and we continue with this on Monday. Yeah, of course.